Isle of Wight has fewer than 100 breeding bird species on it. The mainland of the UK has twice that number. Smaller islands, Lundy, Fair Isle, have fewer still. So smaller islands have fewer species generally. And that is because they're less likely to be colonized, they have fewer habitats, the species populations on them are smaller, and so more likely to go extinct. And we can express this relationship by looking at the number of species on a logarithmic scale against the size of the patch on a logarithmic scale. And the slope is the relationship between the two. And the slope is Z, often a value of 0.25. And there are hundreds of studies on islands and forests and ponds looking at this relationship. Once we have this relationship, we can then say what the consequences of habitat loss would be, because basically we're losing area. So imagine we're losing 1% of species of forest a year as an estimate, as a good estimate. And there are 10 million species globally. Half of them live in tropical forests, and so we're losing 0.25% of species a year. That's 12,500 a year. That's 34 a day, one or two every hour. And that is the basis for the oft-quoted statistics about the impact of habitat loss on species loss. And there's some that say that's too high, because the process of adding habitat is very different from the processes of losing habitat. And some say it's too low, because it's not just habitat loss, it's fragmentation and disturbance. But whatever the case, it is clear that the loss of large amounts of tropical and other habitat is going to result in massive species extinction.